Why should 90% of the population buy the base Mac? I'm not just going to tell you, I'm going to show you. Let's go.
Yeah.
Welcome back to my channel. So what I want to do today is I want to show you why I think 90% of people should buy the base Mac here and why it really makes a lot of sense. But I'm not going to just tell you about this. I'm going to show you some examples. So stay tuned for all these examples. I'm going to show you some load time examples, and I'm going to show you basically video editing on an external drive, how fast it is as well. Stay tuned for that. So what I want to do, first of all, let's go over to my screen over here. And if I go over, I'm just going to do a screen sharing here, and it's basically a QuickTime video. So go ahead and let's take a look at my screen. First thing I want to show you is I have an M1 base model MacBook Air here. And if you look at it, they're $999 now on Apple. This is Apple's website. You can probably get them for $850, or at least you could get them for $850. If you look down here though, if you want to add storage to the system, you can see, and we've talked about this before, it's $400 for a terabyte and $800 for 2 terabytes. Think about that. That's, you can buy 2 MacBook Airs. You know, another $800, you can buy a whole nother system, whole nother computer. So why would you do that? Why would you spend the money on that? I use an inline external drive here. I'll have close-ups of this. You can see them on my screen, so you can see that up close. That's the actual disk that I use a lot of times, but I have a lot of them because I do reviews. So if you look at that, that's a great one to pick up. Here they are. I mean, you can get a 512 gigabyte. If you look at my screen, for $59, which is incredible. You can also get a 1 terabyte one for $99. So incredible costs on those externals. Inline work really good. I'll have links to all these in the description. So check out all these ones I'm going to show you. They're in my video description. The next one is going to be, if you kind of go down the line, it's going to be this one. Where did I put it? It's right here. It's blue on my screen. It's black here. But this is an A data SSD drive. This is, let me see, 480 gigabytes, $59. And then I have another one here from Van Sunny. It's a little unknown company that I use. It's really fast, actually. And again, you can pick these up for 500 gigs, $64, all the way down to like 120 extra gigs for $29. You can see it here on my screen. So really good pricing on these, but I'm gonna show you the inline today. So what I wanna do is, if you go over to my screen here, and I'll go through this quickly, I have 4 files here. They're about 6 to 7 gigabytes of space on these, and you can see them here. So if I go ahead and select all of these, I'm gonna load these, I'm gonna copy these right, actually let me go like this. I'm gonna go there, and I'm gonna go, well, you know what? I'm just going to drag them in. So I'm just going to drag these right into this folder over here on the same Mac. And you can see how fast that was. It's using the external storage of the Mac. It takes 2 seconds to load those. Ultra fast, right? I mean, they're super, super fast into that, and you'd have no complaints. It's almost instantaneous. So how much time do you lose if you have an external SSD drive? Even this is not even the fastest one. So if I go ahead and you look at my screen here, let me go ahead and open this up again. And I take those 4 files just like that. And then I go ahead and open up this inline drive, and I'm just gonna put them in a specific folder here, so inside of this folder. And I'm gonna go ahead and just drag these in over here. What's gonna happen is, look at this now. You're gonna wait, it's gonna have to go through this. It's gonna keep copying. It says about 10 seconds left or so. So as you can see, it goes through the list. It's copying that full 6 to 7 terabytes in here. And it varies in, you know, how fast it can do, but it's about 10 or 12 seconds of time there, and it's got it in there. So the difference is about 2 seconds versus about 12 seconds, or even sometimes it's a lot less than that when you get into bigger files or bigger chunks of files or smaller files. It just depends on the drive and a lot of other things. But you're talking seconds for most of those transfers. It's still gonna be fast enough for most. And so what I recommend is, number one, just using those drives like this for your external storage. Now, people are gonna say, well, I do video editing and I do stuff like that. And that's kind of the whole point of this video. I wanted to show you a couple things here. So let's go back to my screen here. And I actually have, you know, I have iMovie up here, just using iMovie. And you can see, obviously, on an M1 Mac, you know, scrolling, and when I go through the video here, the timeline, you can see how smooth everything is. There's no stuttering, nothing like that. Everything works perfectly smooth. Everything is based off of, I mean, using the internal hard drive here. But a lot of people didn't know this. You can go ahead, and I'll go ahead and do this. It's gonna take a little while, we'll come back to it. But you can go ahead and you can copy, let me just show you. So if you go into Finder and you find your movies directory, you can take your iMovie library like this, and you can take it and you can copy it right into that external drive over here, just like that. And that happens to be, let me see, 24.25 gigabytes. So 24.25 gigabytes, I'm taking that and moving it right into the external drive over here. And that's my whole iMovie library, right? So as that's copying, it's gonna take, you know, for that many gigabytes, it might take a little bit less than a minute or so. The key here is, now I don't have to worry, since that directory has been moved into the external drive over here, it's not taking up all the space on my computer. You know, obviously I only have 256 gigs on this base model. It's not taking any of that space. It's all taking up the space on the external. And that's very cheap storage. So what I wanted to say is, let me just show you now, once this loads in and this is all completed and everything, I'm going to go ahead and shut down iMovie basically. And actually, while this is copying, I might shut it down right now just so I don't mess anything up. So let me go ahead and shut this down, iMovie. So I'm going to quit iMovie. All right, so that copied over. And if I go back over here to my, let's go ahead and close this down. So if I go into my inland drive over here, you can see that the iMovie library is right there, 25 gigabytes. So it's on that drive now. Now if I go back down and I open up iMovie just like this, iMovie will search for that directory and it knows where it is. So now it's basically running off of that external drive. If I remove the external drive and I can't find that movie library, it'll create a new one and it'll create it on the computer. But for now, as long as I have this drive connected, it'll find that movie library that's sitting on the external drive. So now this is running right off the external drive. And as you can see, I mean, in a nutshell, I'm not going to show too much, but basically everything in here, you know, if I play this, everything will be super smooth. I mean, it's running off an external SSD drive. You don't have to really worry. It's fast enough, you know, for 1080p and even 4K. These are 4K videos. So I'm running, you know, off of a Panasonic G7, and it's running perfectly smooth, and I'm basically rendering based, you know, I haven't rendered yet, but I'm creating the movie off of here. Rendering will be a little bit slower as well because the drive's slower. But as you can see, I just moved 25 gigabytes off of there and now it's sitting on there and I can create movies and do everything, take this with me, and I can have multiple iMovie libraries on multiple different external drives and everything works perfectly fine. So as you can see, there's very little difference. I mean, there's gonna be no stuttering or anything on the timeline. You can do whatever you wanna do and it works perfectly the same. I mean, most people won't notice the difference and you're going to be saving maybe a little bit of time here, a little bit of time there, but overall it's exactly the same, you know, as far as the experience, as far as I'm concerned. So the moral of the story is, you know, you basically don't need to buy $800 worth of storage, even if you do basic video editing like I do and stuff for a YouTube channel. So really what you want to do is you want to put all of your important programs and stuff, you know, your base programs on the Mac. Like if you have different applications and programs, all your important files you can encrypt and stuff. But things like the movie files or your picture files or, you know, videos, whatever, you move them onto the external just like I did. iMovie's a little bit, I mean, you can do this with all the different types of stuff. I mean, whether you use Final Cut Pro or anything like that, but it all works the same. And I just wanted to show people why I always say that most people don't need the power of this. They don't need any more. This is plenty of power for them and they should always stick with the base model. So long story short, let me know what you guys think. Just want to make some content here that's hopefully a little bit, you know, enjoyable. Hopefully I didn't bore you to death, but just wanted to show why don't, if you're thinking about getting anything, the only thing you should really consider is the 16 gigs of RAM. That's something that's debatable if you do a lot of movie editing and stuff like that. But beyond that, the storage is one thing you should never add unless you absolutely have to, because the external storage is getting so good and so cheap now, you can just connect it in. And as long as you don't mind too much of carrying that around with you, it's a really good option and you save hundreds of dollars. So anyways, I hope this helped. We'll talk to everybody soon. Subscribe to my channel if you can, help me grow. We'll talk to you soon. Peace.